Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We'll be right back. The House will come to order. The pledge today will be led by Margaret Lyons, Park Hill Elementary, Denver, Colorado, Autumn Rhoda, Bear Creek Elementary, Highlands Ranch, Colorado, and Wyland Hall, Discovery Canyon Campus, Colorado Springs, Colorado.
Please join us in the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mr. Culler, please call the roll.
Representatives Arndt, Becker J., Becker K., Brown, Buck, Buckner excused, Carver, Conti, Corum, Court, Danielson, Del Grosso, Dorr, Duran, Esgar, Everett, Fields, Foote, Garnett, Janal, Hamner, Humphrey, Joshi, Kagan, Kaiser, Klingenschmidt, Kraftharp, Landgraf, Lawrence, Websock, Lee, Onteen, Lundeen, McCann, Melton, Mitch Bush, Moreno, Navarro, Neville, Nordberg, Pabon, Pedersen, Primavera, Priola, Rankin, Ransom, Rosenthal, Representative Rosenthal.
Representative Rosenthal excused.
Rupe, Ryden, Sane, Salazar, Sias is excused. Singer. Tate.
Thank you.
Thurlow. Tyler.
Oh no, I can read it. Thank you.
Van Winkle. Vigil. Willett. Williams. Wilson. Windholz. Winter. Young. Madam Speaker.
With 62 present and 3 excused, a quorum is present. Representative Van Winkle.
Thank you, Madam Speaker, and happy National Jelly Bean Day, members. I move the reading of the journal for Tuesday, April 21st be dispensed with and that it be approved as corrected by our very able Chief Clerk.
You have heard the motion that the journal be adopted as corrected by our very able Chief Clerk. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, no.
No.
Motion carries. Announcements and introductions. Representative Williams.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. And members, if you can just listen up for one moment, I would like to recognize the members of the Enlisted Association today. I'm happy to host them at their first day at the Capitol. The Retired Enlisted Association, their mission is to enhance the quality of life for uniformed services, enlisted personnel and their families, and survivors. The TREA National Organization is celebrating their 50th anniversary this week and has chosen their day at the Capitol for their celebration. The Enlisted Association was founded in 1963, and they were chartered by Congress in 1992. We have 40 members of the TREA organization visiting us today, and so would you please join me in welcoming the TREA organization. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Members, could we have your attention at the well, please? Please keep the side conversations down. Representative Tate.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I am very happy to introduce today and welcome the speech and debate team program students from Cherry Creek High School, one of my favorite high schools in Colorado, and I believe they're up here, so if y'all could give them a round of applause. I'd also like to welcome Ms. Karen Fisher from the Cherry Creek School District School Board. She's waving at us right now, observing us closely. And lastly, members, you know, we're debating a school testing bill today, I presume. And if our debate proves insubstantial, we can certainly welcome these fine students to come down and talk about the bill on our behalf. So I'll let you know they're available to do that. Thank you very much.
Representative Salazar.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. And I think they probably left. I saw them over here just a bit ago, but I want to welcome students from Mapleton's public school district, quite literally one of the best school districts in the state, and their teacher, Judy Newman Lee. If we could give them a hand, I don't think they're around anymore, but give them a hand in absentia. Thank you.
Representative Fields.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. It's a pleasure to serve with you. Good morning, colleagues.
Excuse me for just a minute, Representative Fields. Please put your attention to the well and give those who are speaking the respect that they deserve. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I just want to rise in strong support to acknowledge the TREA organization for being here. I want to thank you for your 50 years of service. My dad was able to achieve the highest rank as an enlisted serviceman. He was a sergeant first class major. Sergeant First Class, and so I know what it's like to sacrifice, because I saw him sacrifice for this country, 2 terms in Vietnam, once in Korea, and so I saw my mom also sacrifice, and I will never forget the sacrifice that they made, the devotion that you have made to this country, and I just want to say thank you, because when I think about your service, I think about your courage, I think about your commitment, I think about your dedication, and I just want you to know that we will never forget. I remember when my dad came home from Vietnam, there wasn't a parade for him. There wasn't a lot of handshaking for him when he came back from Vietnam. And I never said to him, "Welcome home." I just said, "Dad, I missed you." And I never said, "Welcome home." So for those of you who are here today, and no one has ever said, "Welcome home," I'm letting you know on behalf of the Colorado House of Representatives, I want to say, welcome home. Job well done.
Representative Lee.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I'd like to give a welcome to a former illustrious member of the Colorado House, Representative Wes McKinley.
Welcome, Representative McKinley. Representative Tyler.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I think that's Representative Cowboy, actually.
Representative Primavera. And Representative Foote.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Members just want to take a moment to welcome a group that's down here. The Boulder Police Department is here. They're sitting over here. If you guys could just stand up and be recognized, please. Thank you for being here.
Representative Primavera.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. And I just wanted to give a special shout out for the chief of the Boulder Police Department, Chief Testa. He's one of my constituents, and I just want to thank them for the great work that they do.
Welcome, Boulder Police, and that you and Foote and Representative Primavera can share a $2 fine on that. Representative Ryden.
Thank you, Madam Speaker, and I want to join my colleagues in welcoming our TRIA folks today. I'm not sure if you realize that a lot of these folks retired from military service and went on to second and third careers and have remained very close to each other, and it's really great to see this group get together and stay together and have fun together. So I also welcome you down to the Capitol today. And members of some business for the State Veterans and Military Affairs Committee. If you are interested in the bills that we have up today, we are changing the order of presentation. The first bill up will be Senate Bill 227 with Representatives Melton and Van Winkle. The second bill will be House Bill 1354 with Representative Moreno. And the third bill up will be Senate Bill 91 with Representative Willett. And we will be back in our usual place in LSBA, and we'll see you there on adjournment. Thank you.
Representative Quorum.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. We're hawking our wares again today. You know, lovely shirts and jackets for sale here. If you want to pay a little bit extra, you can actually get one with your name on it. If you want to buy some with Don Quorum's name on it, there's a 10% discount. I need these in by Friday.
Representative Tyler.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. And are we allowed to do commercial announcements in the well? I guess so, but I think if we do a quorum, we ought to get a 50% discount at least, but that's up to you. Anyway,
What you aren't allowed to do is have conversations at the well, but please proceed, Representative Tyler.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I would beg your further indulgence to make two announcements. One of them is Transportation Committee is going to have a couple interesting presentations today, and anyone is welcome. One of those presentations is on by the American Petroleum Institute on oil and gas economics. That's at 2 o'clock, but if you come into that one, it should be very interesting. I would also say it's almost required to come at 1:30, where we have a presentation by the Department of Natural Resources on climate change effects in Colorado. So very balanced presentation there. And the second announcement, I would like to welcome my sister, Terry Scott, who is here today. And hello, Terry, and thanks for coming down to the Capitol.
Representative McCann. No, you know, oh, okay. Representative Rosenthal.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Sort of multiple issues today. So actually, there was a group earlier of students from France. They are from a little town near Brest, France, which is the sister city of Denver since 1948, one of the very first sister cities in the country. So they were here earlier, and so I'd love to greet them. And of course, you don't have to clap because they're gone from the chamber, but just to let you know that they were here. Second of all, at noon today, there is a presentation of four tuk-tuks. Again, these are three-wheeled vehicles that you would find in China or India or in Thailand. And so they're going to be out front on the western side of the Capitol in the circle area. So you'll be able to sit in one, ride in one, kind of see what that is all about. And they're going to have food there too. So if you're hungry, you're welcome to have some food in one of our tuk-tuks. And next.
Representative Norberg.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Not to be outdone by tuk-tuks. we have our Aerospace and Defense Caucus luncheon today at noon in room 107 in the basement. We're going to be hearing an overview on Colorado's defense and military installation assets and what a potential BRAC base realignment and closure process might mean to Colorado. So aides, interns, all legislators, everybody is welcome, and lunch will be provided. So today at noon in 107. Thank you.
Representative Salazar.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Madam Speaker, now they're here, kids from Mapleton School District. Hey, guys. Let's wave. Let's everyone give them a hand. Just want to acknowledge your presence. Thank you very much, Madam Speaker.
Representative Quorum.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I actually need a clarification from the Speaker. I need to know if you think it is proper for a chairman to schedule a presentation and then announce that he will not be there to the committee. Shouldn't that be a $2 fine?
Well, let me think. How full is our jar down there? we're getting close to the end of the session and we want to provide a really good lunch. So I'm inclined to go on the side of fines whenever I have a chance. So Representative Tyler, let's see if you can defend not having a $2 fine on that.
Madam Speaker, I object. Since okay. The reason I'm not going to be there, I've been called to an office of somebody of high standing in this chamber. So if I have a $2 fine, I would suggest the Speaker levy a $2 fine upon herself.
Okay. So, you know what? I know this is important, but we have quite a lot of important business to do today. So you two guys figure it out, and you get $2 in the pot over there, if you would, for me, please. So Representative Lawrence and Representative Pabon.
Oh, man, you're going to make me speak from the left side.
Yeah.
Members, tonight is the Hop the Vote team meeting. So if anybody is interested in being on the House team to brew beer for the next Great American Beer Fest, this is your opportunity tonight, and I'm going to let my cohort tell you where and when.
Members, not only is this the meeting of the Hop the Vote team, but this is our opportunity to defend our trophy at the Great American Beer Fest. This is where it starts, tonight at 5:00 at the Lost Highway Brewing Company, which is at 520 East Colfax Avenue. So just to keep in mind where that is, we're at 200 East Colfax Avenue. So it's a mere 3 blocks away, just up Colfax. So let's meet tonight at 5:00. Let's start working and planning. Probably not brewing, but maybe having a couple of craft beers, and let's get ready to win.
Representative Foote.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Members of House Finance, hopefully they'll be having the Hop the Vote till about midnight tonight, because we're going to be busy. We've got 8 bills. We had 10, just to let you know, but we're going to lay over 2 of them. We have House Bill 1346 first, followed by 1366, followed by 1301. House Bill 1335, Representative Sias's bill, will be laid over. Then we have 1247, House Bill 1258, House Bill 1236. House Bill 1399, Representative Escar's bill, will be laid over until April the 29th at the sponsor's request. And then 1332 and 1226. We'll see you at 1:30 p.m., LSBA House Finance.
Representative Rosenthal, Landgraf. Representative Landgraf.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Members, remember tomorrow, Thursday, is the Workforce Development Caucus. It's the last one of the year in room 356. Lunch will be offered. Thank you.
Representative McCann. And members, may we have your attention for one more announcement. I believe this is a tribute.
Oh, thank you, Madam Speaker. And I particularly want my colleagues over on this side of the aisle to listen to this, because today is Elephant Appreciation Day. And I have a tribute. I need to tell you, too, that I had a little elephant stuffed animal called Ellie when I was a kid, and since then, elephants have been my favorite animal. So just so you know that. Today is Elephant Appreciation Day, and I have a tribute to Ivory Free Colorado, which I would like Mr. Kohler to read.
May we have your attention, members, and please take your side conversations outside.
State of Colorado, the House of Representatives, convened in the 70th General Assembly, hereby extend sincere commendations to Ivory Free Colorado. There are only about 500,000 wild African elephants remaining worldwide, representing a 90% decrease in population over the last 100 years. During the past 3 years, approximately 100 African elephants a day are slaughtered by poachers for their ivory tusks. Trafficking of ivory is an underlying cause of this poaching epidemic. Trafficking of ivory destabilizes nations by engendering corruption and by funding criminal and terrorist organizations. The poaching epidemic has resulted in the deaths of over 1,000 African park rangers who were protecting wildlife. Ivory Free Colorado includes Colorado and African residents who are committed to reducing ivory demand, building international cooperation to combat the killing of African elephants, and increasing public awareness of ivory trafficking. The members of the Colorado House of Representatives recognize their many efforts and wish them continued success. On request of Representative Beth McCann, given this 22nd day of April, 2015, State Capitol, Denver.
Representative McCann.
Thank you, and please be seated, colleagues, and thank you for your attention. All kidding aside, elephants really have been my favorite animal for a long time, ever since I had that little stuffed elephant as a child. And today there are only about 500,000 African elephants remaining, which is a 90% decrease in population. In the past 3 years, 100,000 African elephants have been slaughtered by poachers at a rate of 35,000 to 40,000 per year, which averages out to about 100 per day. At this rate, African elephants are threatened with extinction within the next 10 to 15 years. The trafficking of ivory, both legal and illegal, is causing the poaching epidemic. And I would note that other states, including New York and New Jersey, have acted to ban the ivory trade. So I would like us to recognize Elephant Appreciation Day, and I want to mention that the National Strategy for Combating Wildlife Trafficking was released on February 11th, 2014, and includes some of the following principles: to strengthen domestic and global enforcement of ivory trafficking, to reduce demand for ivory at home and abroad, and building international cooperation, public-private partnerships to combat the poaching of African elephants and the trafficking of ivory. It also recommends closing existing loopholes in the U.S. federal regulations that too broadly exempt ivory antiques, ivory acquired before African elephants were protected, and so forth. It also supports increasing public awareness that ivory trafficking is a criminal enterprise worth at least $100 million per year that threatens international security, triggers global human rights offenses, and devastates the ecology and economy of many countries. And I would also like to point out, members, that ivory trafficking destabilizes nations by engendering corruption and funding criminal organizations such as the Lord's Resistance Army, which you might be familiar with, that operates in Uganda and Rwanda, Al-Qaeda, Al-Shabaab, and those responsible for the recent attack at the Westgate shopping mall in Nairobi, in which 67 people died. They are tying this illegal poaching of ivory to these terrorist organizations. The United Nations Security Council has recognized that wildlife traffickers fund the armed groups that commit many of these human rights violations. I also want to mention that African elephants are of great symbolic and aesthetic value to humans, long featured in art, literature, and childhood stories. Who can forget Dumbo, for example? African elephants are highly intelligent, and they form lifelong attachments to their family members. And they represent a keystone species, meaning they maintain structural balance of the ecosystem by ensuring the well-being of other species as they remove trees from the savanna to grasslands and so forth. So, members, I would suggest that we need to be aware of this ivory trafficking. I think most of us have ivory jewelry in our homes, things that we purchased before we even knew about this illegal poaching and the terrible devastation of our African elephant population. So, in honor of Elephant Appreciation Day and in honor of Ivory Colorado, which has come together to help combat this trafficking, I am honoring Ivory Free Colorado today. There will be a press conference at noon, which any of you are welcome to join us in the West Foyer, and we will have some ivory that has been confiscated in these efforts. So thank you very much for your attention. I would like to recognize Jerry Touchton from the Defenders of Wildlife, who is here in the back, if you would wave. Jay Touchton. He has been very instrumental in helping with this effort, and many of our members here of Colorado travel to Africa to help those rangers who are working so hard to stop this poaching of African elephants. So thank you very much for your attention.
Are there further announcements and introductions? The speaker has one. Representative Dave Young will replace Representative Buckner on the Education Committee today only. And the next order of business is third reading, final passage of bills. Members, please take your seat for third reading. And Mr. Kohler, please read the title of House Bill 1235.
Yeah.
Madam Majority Leader.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move to lay over House Bill 1235 until tomorrow, April 23rd.
The motion is to lay over House Bill 1235 until tomorrow. Seeing no objection, so ordered. Mr. Kohler, please read the title of House Bill 1001.
House Bill 1001 by Representatives Pedersen and Garnett, also Senator Todd, concerning distribution of monies for scholarship programs that assist early childhood education professionals in obtaining post-secondary credentials in early childhood education in connection with making an appropriation.
Madam Majority Leader.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move for the passage of House Bill 1001 on third reading and final passage.
The question is the passage of House Bill 1001 on third reading and final passage. Seeing no discussion, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 33 ayes, 30 noes, and 2 excused, House Bill 1001 is passed. Co-sponsors. Close the machine. Mr. Kohler, please read the title of 1325. Madam Majority Leader.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move to lay over House Bill 1325 until tomorrow, April 23rd.
The motion is to lay over House Bill 1325 until tomorrow. Seeing no objection, so ordered. Mr. Kohler, please read the title of House Bill 1088.
House Bill 1088 by Representative Winter, also Senator Crowder, concerning the creation of the Interagency Farm School Grant Program in connection with making an appropriation.
Madam Majority Leader.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move for the passage of House Bill 1088 on third reading and final passage.
The question is the passage of House Bill 1088 on third reading and final passage. Seeing no discussion, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 33 ayes, 30 noes, and 2 excused, House Bill 1088 is passed. Co-sponsors. close the machine. Mr. Kohler, please read the title of House Bill 1290.
House Bill 1290, Representatives Salazar and Esgar, also Senator Guzman, concerning prohibiting a peace officer from interfering with a person lawfully recording a peace officer-involved incident.
Madam Majority Leader.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move for the passage of House Bill 1290 on third reading and final passage.
The question is the passage of House Bill 1290 on third reading and final passage. Seeing no discussion, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 47 ayes, 16 noes, and 2 excused, House Bill 1290 is passed. Co-sponsors. Close the machine. Madam Majority Leader.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move to lay over the second reading calendar until tomorrow, April 23rd.
The motion is to lay over the second reading calendar until tomorrow, the 23rd. See no objection, so ordered. The next order of business is consideration of Senate amendments to House bills. Mr. Kohler, please read the title of House Bill 1212.
House Bill 1212, Representative Becker Kay, also Senators Kerr and Merrifield, concerning making permanent the State Board of Land Commissioners' authority to sell state trust land to local governments.
Representative Casey Becker.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Apologies. This has been several days, and I didn't know it was actually going to come up today. Thank you. I concur in Senate amendments to House Bill 1212.
Was that a motion? I didn't hear it.
I move to concur with the Senate amendments to House Bill 1212.
The motion is to concur with Senate amendments to House Bill 1212. See no discussion. Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote on concurrence on House Bill 1212. Representative Conte, Representative Danielson, and Representative Lee. Close the machine. With 63 ayes, no noes, 2 excused, and 2 absent, the motion to concur to Senate amendments on House Bill 1212 is passed. Madam Majority Leader.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move for the repassage of House Bill 1212 as amended.
The motion is for repassage of House Bill 1212 as amended. Seeing no discussion, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 40 ayes, 39 ayes, 24 noes, and 2 excused, House Bill 1212 is repassed as amended. Co-sponsors. Close the machine. Mr. Kohler, please read the title of House Bill 1198.
House Bill 1198, Representative Foote, also Senator Stebbins, concerning enactment of the 2008 amendments to the Uniform Interstate Family Support Act.
Representative Foote.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move to concur with Senate amendments to House Bill 1198.
The question is to concur with Senate amendments to House Bill 1198. Representative Foote.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. As I'm sure you all recall, by reading this bill several times, I'm sure, prior to today, we have a Uniform Interstate Family Support Act that makes sure that we can enforce child support actions that are from the state of Colorado throughout the United States. And in 2008, there was a uniform law that made changes to this Uniform Interstate Family Support Act, or that would make those changes, that would also make those orders enforceable internationally as well. The 2008 law was proposed by the Uniform Law Commission. It was adopted by the federal government in 2014. We are conforming, and the Senate amendments simply make a couple of other changes that would further conform us to the law that was passed by Congress last year. So I ask for an aye vote.
Is there further discussion on concurrence on House Bill 1198? Seeing none, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 63 ayes, no noes, and 2 excused, the motion to concur with Senate amendments on House Bill 1198 is passed. Madam Majority Leader.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move for the repassage of House Bill 1198 as amended.
The question is for repassage of House Bill 1198 as amended. Seeing no discussion, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 48 ayes, 15 noes, and 2 excused, House Bill 1198 is repassed as amended. Co-sponsors. Close the machine. Mr. Kohler, please read the title of House Bill 1218.
House Bill 1218 by Representative Fields, also Senator Johnston, concerning requiring certain disclosures by defense-initiated victim outreach specialists.
Representative Fields.
Madam Speaker, I move that the House concur with the Senate amendments to House Bill 1218.
The question is to concur with Senate amendments to House Bill 1218. Representative Fields.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Members, what the Senate did is they add 2 points to provide more clarity to the bill. Basically, they said that a defense victim outreach person must identify their legal name as well as to identify the agent that they're working for. I ask for an aye vote.
Is there further discussion on concurrence on House Bill 1218? Seeing none, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 63 ayes, no noes, and 2 excused, the motion to concur with Senate amendments to House Bill 1218 is passed. Madam Majority Leader.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move for the repassage of House Bill 1218 as amended.
The motion is for repassage of House Bill 1218 as amended. Seeing no discussion, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 63 ayes, no noes, and 2 excused, House Bill 1218 is repassed as amended. Co-sponsors. Close the machine. Mr. Kohler, please read the title of House Bill 1280.
House Bill 1280 by Representative Young, also Senator Grantham, concerning the creation of capital reserve and certain cash funds.
Representative Young.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move we concur with Senate amendments to House Bill 1280.
The motion is to concur with amendments to House Bill 1280. Please proceed, Representative Young.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Normally, I think hissing would be in order because we never like it when the Senate messes with our bills. But in this case, Senator Grantham, our colleague on the Joint Budget Committee, did fine work in further defining what depreciation is, and those additional definitions add real value to the bill. So I urge your aye vote on the concurrence.
Seeing no further discussion on the question of concurrence with Senate amendments on House Bill 1280, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 63 ayes, no noes, and 2 excused, the motion to concur in Senate amendments to House Bill 1280 is passed. Madam Majority Leader.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move for the repassage of House Bill 1280 as amended.
The motion is for repassage of House Bill 1280 as amended. Seeing no discussion, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 63 ayes, no noes, and 2 excused, House Bill 1280, the motion is repassed as amended. Co-sponsors. Close the machine. Mr. Kohler, please read the title of House Bill 1242.
House Bill 1242, Representative Danielson, also Senator Aguilar, concerning the right of a medical patient to designate a caregiver to assist the patient with basic tasks following release from a medical facility.
Representative Danielson.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Speaker. Members, I move to concur with Senate amendments to House Bill 1242.
The motion is for concurrence with Senate amendments to House Bill 1242. Representative Danielson, please explain.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Members, House Bill 1242 is a result of a lot of very, very hard work with all the stakeholders involved, the Hospital Association, the seniors advocates, the advocates for the rights of the disabled, and so they made a slight change to the bill and a couple of small changes to the bill on the Senate side, and we're all good to go and very proud of this bill coming out.
Is there further discussion on concurrence on House Bill 1242? Seeing none, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 59 ayes, 4 noes, and 2 excused, the motion to concur in Senate amendments to House Bill 1242 is passed. Madam Majority Leader.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move for the repassage of House Bill 1242 as amended.
The motion is for repassage of House Bill 1242 as amended. Seeing no discussion, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 60 ayes, 3 noes, and 2 excused, the motion to repass House Bill 1242 is passed, as amended. Co-sponsors. Close the machine. Mr. Kohler, please read the title of House Bill 1255.
House Bill 1255, Representatives Doran, Pabon, also Senators Grantham and John, concerning the enforcement of the prohibited use of electronic benefits transfer cards at certain locations.
Mr. Speaker, Pro Tem, Representative Pabon.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move to concur with the Senate. On this one particular issue, I don't know if the Senate actually got it right, but they did something. What they did was they just put a cap on the amount of fines that could be, the amount of the fine that could be levied against the Department of Revenue. They had to do something to make themselves seem
Representative Doar, do you have anything good to add to that?
Well, thank you, Madam Speaker. This really was just a Senate attempt to try to show us they do work over there. So we will, I'll say we support their amendment.
Okay, is there further a motion on concurrence on Senate amendments to further discussion on concurrence to Senate amendments to House Bill 1255? Seeing none, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine with 63 ayes, no noes, and two excused. House Bill 1255, the motion to concur is passed. Madam Majority Leader.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move for the repassage of House Bill 1255 as amended.
The motion is for repassage of House Bill 1255 as amended. Seeing no discussion, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 62 ayes, one no, and two excused, the motion for repassage of House Bill 1255 as amended is passed. Co-sponsors. Close the machine. Mr. Kohler, please read the title of House Bill 1130. Madam Majority Leader.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move to lay over House Bill 1130 until tomorrow, April 23rd.
The motion is to lay over House Bill 1130 until tomorrow. Seeing no discussion, so ordered. Mr. Kohler, please read the title of House Bill 1131.
House Bill 1131 by Representatives Esgar and Lee, also Senator Lambert, concerning the release of information related to critical incidents that occur in facilities operated by the Division of Youth Corrections in connection with making an appropriation.
Representative Esgar.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. We move to concur with the Senate amendments to House Bill 1131.
The motion is to concur with Senate amendments to House Bill 1131. Representative Lee, do you have anything to say about that?
Actually, the Senate did some pretty good things with this bill. They made it retroactive so that information with the Department of Youth Corrections can be obtained back retro to January 1, 2014, and they put some limits on CORA requests, so people who want information can get the information without paying exorbitant fees. So they're good amendments.
Is there further discussion on Senate amendments to House Bill 1131 on concurrence? Seeing none, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 63 ayes, no noes, and two excused, the motion to concur with Senate amendments to House Bill 1131 is passed. Madam Majority Leader.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move for the repassage of House Bill 1131 as amended.
The motion is the repassage of House Bill 1131 as amended. Seeing no discussion, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 63 ayes, no noes, and two excused, House Bill 1131 is repassed as amended. Mr. Kohler, please read the... Co-sponsors. Mr. Kohler, please open the machine. Mr. Kohler, please read the title of House Bill 1187.
House Bill 1187, Representative Lebsack, also Senators Garcia and Sonnenberg, concerning mental health evaluations of licensed veterinarians conducted by a veterinarian peer health assistance program, is ordered by the State Board of Veterinary Medicine.
Representative Lebsack.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Folks, as you remember, this bill came to Senator Sonnenberg and I from the Colorado Veterinarians Medical Association.
And Representative Lebsack, would you be willing to put a motion forward for us here?
Yes, Madam Speaker. I move the House concur with Senate amendments to House Bill 1187.
The motion is to concur with Senate amendments to House Bill 1187. Please proceed.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. As I was saying, that Senator Sonnenberg and I were approached by the Colorado Veterinarian Medical Association over the interim to run this bill on their behalf. And after the bill came out of the House, I met with my co-primes in the Senate and talked to them about some of the concerns that the minority leader, Representative Buck and Representative Sain, brought to my attention on second reading in the well. Many of those concerns, in fact, I think all of those concerns were addressed in amendments in the Senate, one having to do with confidentiality, one having to do with replacing the language has reasonable cause, and the third having to do with the stipulations. And so I'm confident that we addressed all the concerns in the House in Senate amendments and asked for us to concur with the Senate amendments.
Is there further discussion on concurrence on House Bill 1187? Seeing none, Mr. Caller, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 63 ayes, no noes, and 2 excused, the motion to concur with Senate amendments to House Bill 1187 is passed. Madam Majority Leader.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move for the repassage of House Bill 1187 as amended.
The question is repassage of House Bill 1187 as amended. Seeing no discussion, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 40 ayes, 23 noes, and 2 excused, House Bill 1187 is repassed as amended. Co-sponsors. Close the machine. Mr. Kohler, please read the title of House Bill 1214.
House Bill 1214 by Representative Singer, also Senator Cook, concerning opioid analgesics with abuse deterrent properties.
Representative Singer.
Thank you, Madam Speaker, and thank you, Mr. Kohler, for your excellent elocution. I move that the House concur with Senate amendments to House Bill 1214.
The motion is that the House concur with Senate amendments to House Bill 1214. Please proceed, Representative Singer.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. That is hard for me to say as well. The Senate did wake up from their afternoon nap and decided they didn't like the word efficacy in this bill, and so they wanted to, instead of focusing on efficacy of abuse deterrent opioid analgesics, we're going to discuss barriers to, and also they clarified that monies from the general fund will not be used for implementation of this. So that's it, but I do make this promise here. For every bill that they make me concur with, I will amend one of their bills. And with that, I reluctantly ask for an aye vote.
Perhaps I'll have to declare that that is officially not trading votes. So the motion is concurrence with Senate amendments to House Bill 1214. Seeing no further discussion, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 62 ayes, 1 no, and 2 excused, the motion to concur with Senate amendments on House Bill 1214 is passed. Madam Majority Leader.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Despite the Senate's very desperate attempt to be relevant today, I move for the repassage of House Bill 1214 as amended.
The motion is for repassage of House Bill 1214 as amended. Seeing no further discussion, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 38 ayes, 25 noes, and 2 excused, House Bill 1214 is repassed as amended. Co-sponsors. Close the machine. Mr. Kohler, please read the title of House Bill 1173, found on page 7 of your calendar, members, under Conference Committee's report.
House Bill 1173 by Representatives Mitch Bush and Rankin, also Senator Todd, concerning a requirement that motor vehicles have certain traction equipment when driving on the Interstate 70 Mountain Corridor.
Representative Mitch Bush.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move the Conference Committee be discharged and the House recede from its position on House Bill 1173.
The motion is that the Conference Committee be discharged and the House recede from its position on House Bill 1173. Representative Mitch Bush.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. We met yesterday with our 6 members, who were myself, my co-prime sponsor, Representative Rankin, Representative Hamner, Senator Todd, Senator Baumgardner, and Senator Cook. We presented evidence, more evidence on our bill. We also then presented what we felt was a reasonable compromise, which was to go to the version that passed out of the Senate Transportation Committee 5-0, which had a very good amendment, we thought, in compromise, from Senator Scott. The committee vote was, 4-2. That sounds great until you remember that in a joint conference committee, you have to have 2 House members and 2 Senate members. Therefore, our compromise failed.
Representative Rankin.
And as much as the current version that we're receding to converts the bill to a study, and as much as we love studies, this is a critical problem. It does need to be addressed. The I-70 corridor those issues are not going to go away. So receding to the bill at least lets us continue to look at this problem and look for solutions.
Is there further discussion? Representative Tyler.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. As the person who will be chairing the Transportation Legislative Review Committee this summer, where we're going to be doing this study, I would say that this will be my 6th Transportation Legislative Review Committee, and we have looked at this bill every time that we've had a summer TLRC. And I assume we'll come up with some ideas this summer that we've never, ever explored before, and we'll do our best on that. Thank you.
Is there further discussion? The motion before the House is to recede from our position on House Bill 1173. Seeing no further discussion, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 43 ayes, 20 noes, and 2 excused, the motion to discharge the conference committee and to recede to the Senate position on House Bill 1173 is passed. Representative Mitch Bush.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. According to rules, I make the following motion. I move that the House concur in Senate amendments to House Bill 1173.
The motion is to concur in Senate amendments to House Bill 1173. Seeing no further discussion, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Here we go. Okay, we are voting on the motion to concur with Senate amendments to House Bill 1173. Close the machine. With 40 ayes, 23 noes, and 2 excused, the motion to concur in Senate amendments to House Bill 1173 is passed. Madam Majority Leader.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move for the repassage of House Bill 1173 as amended.
The motion is for repassage of House Bill 1173 as amended. Seeing no further discussion, Mr. Kohler, please open the machine and members proceed to vote. Close the machine. With 34 ayes, 29 noes, and 2 excused, House Bill 1173 is repassed as amended. Co-sponsors. Close the machine. Representative Salazar.
Thank you, Madam Speaker, and with much respect to the bill sponsors here, this thing's been studied. It's been studied at infinitum, and so therefore I ask that I move that my name be taken off as a co-sponsor.
Your request is granted to have your name removed as a co-sponsor, Representative Rosenthal.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I would also like to remove my name as a co-sponsor. Thank you.
Representative Rosenthal's name is removed as a co-sponsor. At his request, Representative Tyler.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I also ask that my name be removed as a co-sponsor.
Representative Tyler's name is removed as a co-sponsor at his request. Are there further requests? Representative Pabone. Mr. Speaker Pro Tem.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. If my name is on the bill, I'd like it removed.
So if Representative Pabone's name is listed anywhere on this bill, the request is granted that it be removed. Representative Young.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Well, if we're going to go those kind of motions, I'll do the same. If my name is on that bill, please take it off as a co-sponsor. Thank you.
Okay, I'm going to rule somebody out of order here real quick, but a representative's request is granted to have his name removed as a co-sponsor. Representative Kraft Tharp.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. My name is on there as a co-sponsor, but now I'm asking for it to be removed.
The Representative Kraft's name will be removed as a co-sponsor as requested. Further requests? Seeing none. I think we're at announcements and introductions, are we not, Madam Majority Leader? Announcements and introductions. While you're finding a way to make it down to the well, I would like to wish everybody Happy Earth Day. Try to do something to help your planet today. Representative Pedersen.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. House Education Committee, we are going to be meeting 5 minutes upon adjournment. We need to get through 2 bills and hopefully have time for lunch. So if you're not there, you will be marked absent.
That's rude.
Representative Vigil.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Agriculture, Livestock, Natural Resources Committee, we're going to be down in 10 minutes. If you're not there in 10 minutes, you will be absent. 107.
Representative Lebsack.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. And House Local Government Committee, we're meeting today at 1:30 sharp. We have 4 bills to be heard, so we were going to start right at 1:30.
Further announcements and introductions? Seeing none, Madam Majority Leader.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I move that the House stand in recess until later today at 1 p.m.
The motion is to stand in recess until later today at 1 p.m. Seeing no objection, we are in recess till 1 p.m. this afternoon.